I'd like to introduce Senator Bernie Sanders. We'll also take questions at the end, so if you can hold them till then, we'll thank you very much for that.
Thank you, Sean, and thank you for Environment America, and I thank you for all the excellent work that you and the other environmental organizations are doing. Here's the bottom line. It's not complicated. We're spending $350 billion every single year importing oil from Saudi Arabia, the Middle East, Venezuela, and many other countries. Consumers are seeing enormous volatility in the price of oil. They are seeing greenhouse gas emissions impacting our planet, and they are seeing our dependence on foreign oil lead us into wars that we should not be fighting. Is there an alternative? Well, as Sean just indicated, there most certainly is. Right now, what we are looking at is legislation which will produce 10 million solar rooftops in 10 years. 10 million. What this legislation is co-sponsored by Senators Whitehouse, Cardin, Gillibrand, Merkley, Lautenberg, Leahy, Boxer, and Menendez, and Senator Spector. This legislation has the possibility, the potential to transform the energy system of the United States of America. What it can do is break our dependency on foreign oil. What it can do is bring us to energy independence. What it could do is substantially cut greenhouse gas emissions. And what it can do over a period of time is create well over 1 million good-paying jobs. The idea for this 10 million solar rooftop legislation comes from the state of California, where they are planning over a 10-year period to put 1 million solar rooftops in that state, and they are on target. They are doing exactly what they planned to do. We have just talked to California, and they say that things are going extremely well in their state in this direction. This legislation is supported by Environment America, the Sierra Club, Natural Resources Defense Council, Defenders of Wildlife, the Wilderness Society, and the Center for Biological Diversity. It works pretty simply. What it says is, right now, if you want to install solar panels on your rooftop, it is an expensive proposition. The good news is, recently in Congress, we have passed substantial tax credits. If you want to install solar panels, take advantage of the tax credits, federal tax credits, take advantage of your state tax credits, and after that is done, the federal government will provide you with 50% of the remaining cost. Now, some people say, well, that's a lot of money. Well, it is. It's between $1 and $3 billion a year, but it pales. It pales in the amount of subsidies that we have been given to the fossil fuel industry. It pales in the amount of subsidies we have been giving to the nuclear power industry. The estimate is, and Kent Salazar, Secretary of the Interior, indicated that on public lands alone, large-scale utility-based solar can produce 29% of the electricity needed by households in the United States of America. So we are on the cusp of a revolution, and that is clean energy, that is energy independence, that is a substantial cutback in greenhouse gas emissions, and that is creating jobs in the United States of America. So we're very, very proud to be working with the organizations that are here right now in transforming our energy system to clean energy. And I think when we do that, solar is going to be right at the top of the list. Thank you very much.
Good morning. Thank you, Sean, and thank you, Senator Sanders. I'm Jamie Rezor, executive with Grow Solar. We're founded and headquartered in Senator Sanders' home state of Vermont some years ago. And as Sean said, we are a designer, installer, and developer of solar projects, focusing on residential and commercial, which could include schools, businesses, and also we actually did the one for the Boston Red Sox at Fenway Park as another example. I think Grow Solar is a good example of how a proper policy framework and support for solar can create a lot of jobs. We were started by a couple out of their house in Vermont, and now we operate in about 15 states. We employ directly about 150 employees, but we also spur on a lot of other employee opportunities through our partners and dealers and whatnot. We operate from the East Coast out to California, and even in 2009 and in early 2010, where you know federal statistics say we're shedding jobs each month, you know, we just hired six people in February, which by itself isn't going to turn around the world, but again, it's indicative of what solar can do to create jobs. And these jobs are for the design installation of solar projects. These are jobs that will stay in the U.S. They're engineers, they're electricians, and it's a good cross-section of jobs that can really be a solid backbone for economic growth. And we really, again, appreciate the opportunity to be here and applaud Sean's efforts and those of Senator Sanders' leadership on this issue. Thank you.
Thank you, Sean. Thank you, Senator. I'm Tony Clifford. I'm the CEO of Standard Solar. Standard Solar is a developer and integrator that operates in the mid-Atlantic states. We're headquartered in Gaithersburg, Maryland. We've been in business commercially since the middle of 2006. When I joined the company in early 2007, we had three full-time employees. We've added nearly 70 employees in the past 2 years. We've done more than 500 residential installations and a substantial number of commercial and government installations, including the roof of the Department of Energy headquarters, which is just a few blocks from here, Catholic University. And we recently signed a letter of intent to do one of the largest installations on the East Coast. It's a 6-megawatt facility at the University of Delaware. And I think we are just sort of a good example of what a proper incentive structure and policy structure can do to move solar along. And I think that when you look at something that has a national scope like the 10 million solar rooftops, that can have a really transforming effect on the solar industry. And the senator talked about a cost of $1 to $3 billion a year over 10 years. So even on the worst case, that's somewhere between $20 and $30 billion. And then you look at what we're giving to the fossil fuel industry in terms of oil depletion allowances and other incentives, that I think last year was about $70 billion. So what we're spending over 10 years on this bill is what the oil and gas industry and coal industry gets in a couple of months, in several months. So I mean, this is a transformational effect. This bill could have a transformational effect, and it's not really a very expensive piece of legislation. And I'm ready and willing to support this bill. Thank you.